There we go, we're recording. Morning. Get some light, lots of contrast here. So today, beautiful day in Maple Ridge, BC. We're kind of starting in on day two of our Cummins Swap. Just pulling the front end apart. Couple of things to note when you're pulling the front ends of these apart. Some of the bolts are a bit hard to find. They get very rusty. And especially on these headlight bezels, you can see right here, the bolt that's supposed to be in the light actually unscrewed right out of the light, well, the light bezel, whereas this one didn't. So this guy sits in here like this. There's two screws in the top, and then inside there's two screws here and another one here. And these guys are actually quite hard to find because they're kind of buried in there. So as this one came out, it kind of pushed like this, and I thought it was actually going to crack. It didn't. I was able to get the screw backed all the way out of here, and it didn't break. But yeah, that's taking apart the front end. We're going to pull the rad support out of it. We're going to really go to town on this thing. Hopefully today we'll be able to get a bunch of stuff done. As you've seen in the other videos, this is a 460. So we're gonna yank the 460 out of it. I'm gonna put that down for a second. Just give it a pause. Let me get that out of there. A couple of things to note about the old 460s. This one isn't in too bad a shape, but you can see it's starting to rust in here. There's a bunch of crud in there. This is pretty rusty. Frame looks good. But yeah, I'm gonna order one from, I don't know, possibly Rock Auto or somewhere else. Oh yeah, this corner's toasted here. It's totally gone. Oh yeah, it's El Tosto. I mean, overall, this is a really good truck as far as rust goes. It's not much at all, but there is some. Now, one of the things I was looking at, I don't know if we'll be able to see it here, but if you can see the space between the frame rail and the engine, on this side, just looking down from the exhaust manifold, there's maybe a half inch between the exhaust manifold and the way it lines up with the frame rail. And then on this side, if you look here, there's a good, I'm gonna say 3 to 4 inches on this side. I'll have to measure it just to check and be sure. But that's why your Cummins motor mounts are so offset, is because the motor's offset. Well, at least it looks like it's offset. I'm gonna assume that's for beautiful Mr. Steering Box. But either way, we're gonna try and sort this all out, and hopefully in a little while, gonna get my son over here to give me a hand. We're gonna yank Mr. 460 out and go from there. So we've got a bunch of stuff pulled out so far. What have we got pulled out? We got the radiator coolant tank, washer tank. We've got a spare diff to go in here. We've got the bezel and the grill support, and then some other stuff we've just yarded out. This came out pretty easy. This was not too bad, just locating all the bolts. And it doesn't want to come straight out from here. You kind of have to go twisting up, and then it comes out pretty easy. We've used penetrating fluid on all these little bolts, hopefully to loosen them up a bit, because we're going to need all these little bolts and brackets and things when we put in the new rad support. I'm going to pull the bumper and this lower valance just because I want to be able to, once I take this out, then the motor can just literally come straight out of it. It'll be nice and easy. Won't be too much of a pain. That's the plan either way. So however that works. So this is the start. I might try and do a time lapse. I don't know. See how we can do today. That might be a bit boring. Time lapse of me. The backside of me. Anyways, this is High Power Garage. Just starting in on it. If you've got any questions or comments, please post away. Look at that. Beautiful blue sky. Birds everywhere. my neighbor with his funky antenna, whatever that is, I don't know. But yeah, just a beautiful, beautiful blue sky day in the neighborhood, in the Ford hood. All right, hot par garage. At least we'll have to do it standard, eh? High Park Garage, over and out. Okay, so been at it a couple hours. What time is it now? As you can see, I've had the sun on my face for all morning. Getting a bit rosy in the cheeks. Either way, okay, so what we got here, I'll just pan around. Sorry for the crappy camera action. Okay, so we'll redo that. It's super bright out right now. As you can see, I'm all red-faced because it's all 2.5 hours in the sun. It's a beautiful, beautiful sunny day here today. Okay, so what we got the lower valance pulled off. We got pretty much every bolt undone. So this thing is just like a loose tooth. I got the wrench on the one rad support bolt right through there, as you can see, but it just spins. It's just rusted solid and rust is just falling out of it. So what I think I'm gonna do, I think I'm gonna pull the bumper and then I think I'm gonna just sawzall these off. I'm gonna get a nice little short sawzall blade and just cut them. And because there's not gonna be any rescuing any of this stuff, there's just no way. So I'm just gonna hack those off. The mounts are okay, but I just don't see any way I can save them. So this bolt here was one of the hardest bolts to get. There is the whatever this thing is, I don't know what it is, but it basically sits right there like that, and that bolt, and with the valance in here, you just can't get to it. Thank God for gear wrenches. So we got that all out. Like I said, this is all loose. I pulled the corners out of it just because I wanted to make it so that I could easily get to it. I'm gonna pull the bumper because Mr. 460 is coming out. Mr. 460 is coming out, and Mr. 59's coming is going in. So there's Mr. 59, almost ready to go. Pretty much ready to go. Not 100%, but getting there. I got a bunch of crud on my hands now. Very dirty hands. Look at that. All greasy, grimy, all the rest of it. So yeah, so this is our ongoing project. Our 96 F250 4x4. We got the axle we're gonna put in that. We might even do that first, simply because it's gonna be nice and easy to work on when it's all open and everything. I'm not happy with the amount of crud that gets caught right in the front of the fender here. Right in the front quarter panel and in the front of the rad support. I mean, you can just see it's all just germung in here, right? It's total germung. And yeah, you can see like these things just hold grease and grime and crud. And I mean, all in all, this rad support isn't too bad, except for the fact, like all of them, like right in these pockets, right where it mounts, it's just all rusted to crap. So I don't really think it's repairable. Plus I'm gonna go to a diesel rad support, so I'll pull all this crud out of here and move some stuff around and all the rest of it. Next task is gonna be to get the refrigerant out of it. So I'll talk to one of the guys at work, get the proper refrigerant thing. I'll remove all the refrigerant and then we'll go from there. So do some more crappy camera work.